Hi.
My husband's being silly. Welcome to Painted Love Live. Yeah, this is strange for me. I don't usually do these live things, so if y'all know me, you know I'm very honest about things. And he's giving me the funny eye. But anyway, I figured we would do some painting tonight, and I've got a lot to share with you guys. So yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and start talking to y'all, I guess, as he's setting up the second one. Hold on, stand by. All right, now we got both things going. Painted Love Live. Sorry for my silliness, but y'all know that's just who I am. Anywho, this is a background for a painting that we're doing coming up on the 16th with for Zoography. We're doing a fundraiser to help them out, to help their enclosures and help them build high fences so their animals won't get out. But Zoography is a great, great, I don't know if it's a cause, but it's a, I think it's a nonprofit, and they basically take in animals that either would have been euthanized or maybe someone had as an exotic pet, and now they can't keep the animal. So I'm trying to help them out so they can have open to the public here in Matthews, which I think is awesome. They even have, you know, alligators, wolves, pumas, a cougar, I believe cougar, crazy stuff like that. And I'm really excited to see them, so I wanted to help them out. So we are gonna do a fundraiser night for them. Usually when I do a painting, I try and find an inspiration one. So this is kind of my inspiration. It'll look similar to that when it's done. And so what I'm gonna help with you guys tonight, we're gonna do some snowflakes and probably some trees. This fox, instead of the one, I kind of merge what I'm doing here. So I'm probably gonna do something like these two, but more with a look like that. So those are kind of my inspiration pages. And hopefully I like how it looks in the end, but that's the goal. And so whenever I do a painted night, painted love party night, what I do is I do a demo painting first. And so that way everything works out. I know how to show everybody what to do. And then the night of the party, I will have everything set. Now, trust me, you don't have to be an artist. I promise you that. I may be one, so they say, but you don't have to be one. Even if for mine, I'm gonna draw it by hand, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna have a cutout. So if you don't wanna draw it by hand, which you can that night, you'll be able to actually put something on there smaller than this, trace around it, and then be able to paint inside of it. So don't feel like if you don't have any skills that you can't come to my parties. You absolutely can. I love artists as well too. So, what, babe?
I just want to let you know some of the people who are online watching Yay! Right now. First of all, you are getting massive, massive thumbs up hearts and laughing faces. It doesn't say where they're all coming from, but as soon as I logged on and started watching on the screen, they're flying across the screen.
Oh my gosh. That makes it even creepier that I know people are watching me. So I guess that's the point.
Megan Hopkins is watching.
Hey!
And Nikki's watching.
Oh my gosh. Hey girl.
Jeff Norman's watching.
Hey Jeff!
So you can go ahead and continue.
Okay, cool. I lost my role then where I was.
You were talking about Zoography, and then you were talking about this painting that you're getting ready to do.
Yes. So speaking of Zoography, this is the painting that we're going to do. So I'll show you a little painting and then I'll talk some more about some of the other parties that we're going to have. So I'm going to do something kind of like these little snowflakey things. I have a couple brushes here, and when you come to the parties, I'll have brushes for you too. I usually work with, this is called a wash brush, and because obviously you can get a lot on there and wash it on your canvas. This is a flat brush. I don't know if you can see that. Hey. Flat brush, and these are round brushes. I really like the little guys, but I'll have these for you guys too. So I'm gonna use one of the small round brushes right now, and I have some, I usually like to use some sparkle in my paints. I'm gonna do one of the snowflakes now with some silver. This isn't my usual palette for paint. I'm usually pretty low tech and use a paper plate, but here we go. So I've got some silver paint right now. And for a snowflake, I'm gonna be, let's say, Patrick said to me earlier that I'm like the new Bob Ross, so I said, well, that's some big happy trees paint shoes to fill.
She's the Bob Ross of the next generation starting now.
Yeah, that would be like a dream of mine come true. I used to watch that guy for forever.
So paint some happy trees, please.
I'm gonna paint some happy snowflakes, and then I'll paint some happy trees. So for a snowflake, let's just plop one up here. What you want to do for that is we're going to make kind of like an X. So I'm going to make an X. It's very light, so I need to grab some more paint. Sorry if you can't see that. It's a little light. But that's the idea of snowflakes anyway. They're kind of delicate. So I've got an X going on. X marks the spot. He'll probably pick on me later if I don't smile enough. And then
you don't want to frown in your videos.
But why not? Don't you like my RBF?
Or make the Bryce think lips. That's how you should.
Thinking.
Let me see the Bryce think lips.
Which one's the? Oh yeah, the.
Yeah, there you go. The other one's the duck face. That's the Facebook duck face.
Anyway, I did an X. So apologize if you can't see it too well because it is sparkly, but you'll be able to see it when you come up close to it. So I did an X and then a line down the middle. Great thing about snowflakes is they all look different, so anybody who would be doing it, theirs would look different than mine. And then I'm going to do three little dashes off of each one of these, I guess planks you'd want to call them, on each side. So those would be like the little crystals. I probably do his little thinking face.
He gets it, honestly.
He does.
So tell us about the pickle jar.
Pickle jar?
In front of you.
Oh, my, for my water?
Yeah. Does everybody get their own pickle jar at the Paint and Love
Fest? I forgot I had that. It wouldn't be a pickle jar per se, probably a plastic cup, but if you'd like to bring your own pickle jar, you're more than welcome.
Is that pickle juice that you use in the?
Ew, no. Yeah. I don't think that would go too well on your canvas if you have pickle juice on there.
Did you talk at all about Sweet Caroline's?
No, not yet. So this next Friday, the 8th, y'all who know me have talked to me recently, my art is at this shop called Sweet Caroline's in Williamsburg. And I'm hosting a Painted Love paint and sip night there next Friday. It's 6 o'clock. Tickets are $35. It'll include everything that you need. Same with the other parties, where you'll get your canvas, instruction, all the paint that you need. There you can actually shop for Christmas gifts because there's, I believe, 28 vendors, they can correct me if I'm wrong, but 28 vendors right now that have things from LuLaRoe to, you know, like painted signs and clothes and chocolates. I mean, especially popcorn. I know some of y'all, Nikki, Becca, y'all love your specialty popcorn if you're still on there. But they're at the shop too, so you can also BYOB if you like to paint and do a little drinky-drinky. You know, the more you drink, the better your painting looks. So that's there too. So please take a look. The tickets are on Eventbrite right now. I also have the link on my page so that you will be able to join me. We do have spaces still available, so I'd love to see everybody there, anybody who can make it.
I don't know what the mad faces are for. There's some mad faces coming across the screen.
Why are you mad, bro?
Let me tell you some of the people who joined. Joe Seibert is watching.
Hey.
Mark Berry.
Hey, Mark.
And JC just joined.
What up, JC?
Mark says, hi, Chris. Love you.
Aw, that's sweet. Thank you. JC, thanks for picking up my real estate sign the other day. I appreciate you. All right, back to these. So the snowflake, in between my X's, I've got little dots, kind of make little crystals. So there's three dots on each side. I'm going to do a couple other little happy little dots over here too, coming out and in between each one.
Okay, I will tell you it's a hard.
It's probably hard to see.
It's actually close to impossible to see.
Yeah.
You might want to move into some happy trees.
Okay, I'll move to some happy trees. I'll show y'all later and you'll be able to see my happy snowflakes. All right, so for...
JC says, love you, you're welcome.
Thank you, babe. So for a tree, there's a lot of ways you can paint a tree, and with really a lot of different brushes. Stand by. So Mr. Bob Ross always loved the fan brush. Those are really good for painting trees. You could do it with really anything, but I'm going to use my flat brush. So for my paint, I have a pretty bright neon green, and it's a little brighter than I would like. So if anyone remembers back to grade school, the complementary colors and things like that, so red, if you put it in your green that's too bright, will actually make it darker. So that's what I'm doing here to make my green more what I'm looking for in the scene here. So I've got a little bit of that mixed up already. what I'm going to do first for my tree, just kind of like in this picture, I'm going to do a lighter one in the background and a darker one in the front. So I'm going to put this one here. I'm going to do a straight line down. So I've got, let's go, let's do a little Bob Ross, go like a Sorry, he made me laugh. I no lie, I used to watch that all the time. So that's kind of like our trunk of the tree. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm going to do the start with the bottom and work my way up, because you wanna think like a tree, it stacks, and then the top is gonna be your, I don't know, smallest and closest to you. So I'm taking pretty loaded brush and I'm going out in sweeping motions from the middle out to the end. And this is really, the thing is with acrylic paint in particular, is you're gonna be doing a lot of layers. So anytime I put anything down, usually there'll be multiple layers on top of it with other colors. You'll start with kind of your base color, and then you'll add a darker and a lighter to really bring out the depth and the layers of it. So I'm kind of going up to the next layer. Each one's gonna get a little shorter as I work my way up. I know I'm getting my concentration face, I can feel it already. We're gonna go out to the sides and the middle, and then out to, what's that, am I right?
How would you handle colorblind folk at a painted love party?
Is that you asking it, babe, or is it someone else?
Someone else.
Well, I think for you colorblind folk, you will do just fine, because I'll have probably the colors that you already need. And if you want my expertise and opinion in judging the color, I can help you out with that. But usually just adding a little bit of more, you'll probably see the shades, because I know from talking from Leo, like with the traffic light, you could tell which one it is by the shade. So you'll notice when you add, say, more red to green, that the shade changes. And that's what I look for.
Brandy Harrison just joined.
Hey, neighbor. Virginia Beach neighbor. So again, I'm working on this base layer. I need some more green, so I'm kind of grabbing in this bright green. I'm gonna grab some more of my red to make the green more of a, I guess more of a sage green, more of an evergreen. All right, still working my way up.
So going back to the colorblind thing, what about artistic ability? How important is that? If for people coming to do these paint parties, you're going to be teaching them how to paint. You're going to be taking them zero to hero. So
they will be just fine. Like we talked about in the beginning, if they can't paint a fox, I will have the fox outline for them. And it will be kind of like a paint by number. And that's my goal, is if you've painted before, you're going to have a great time. You probably won't need as much instruction from me. And I'm cool if people, I'm perfectly happy if the canvases look completely different. If everybody's looks different, I think that makes it even more fun. But I'm also happy if someone's just having a good time, wants some extra help. They need maybe like, well, how did you do that? Can you tell me that again? I used to train for a long time. So I'm used to taking people from zero to hero, as you say.
Awesome. So Becca just joined.
Hey, girl.
And Brandy says, miss you, neighbors.
Aw.
Make sure that they know, because most people are watching this on your Facebook, that they need to follow the McCormick Meadows Art Facebook.
Yes, please. McCormick Meadows Art.
Because we won't always air these episodes on our personal Facebooks. We're just trying to get everybody go and like us on McCormick Meadows. There's going to be other stuff, too. We're going to show me carving and some other things as well.
Shameless plug, right?
Yeah.
So if you search it, I think if you search McCormick Meadows, it should come up. For some reason, the icon is a crab, painting of a crab, which takes me to, actually, you can see it right here. The icon will look kind of like that, that you'll see for us. That's where you know you have the right page, because I think there's some like neighborhoods and complexes or something that also are called McCormick Meadows. And since you see this, if you're like me and everyone asks you, what do you want for Christmas? And I'm usually like, I have no idea, or I really don't want a gift card because that doesn't say you love me, but find a way to say you love me. But
that's what you tell me.
Yeah, I do. So I kind of came up with this to help out people like that. So if you have someone asking you what you would like and you really don't know, tell them that you would like a paint party. So this is for a paint night, What you could do with this is you could come to one of my public paint nights, like the one I have at Sweet Caroline's next week, or like the one we're doing for Zoography. By the way, the one for Zoography is going to be, where was it at the...
It is at Almond and Beck Realty in Yorktown, George Washington Highway.
Thank you. And I'll have that post out later on tonight so you can get tickets for that. But you'll be able to use that for one of the public parties, fundraising parties. We've got some fundraising coming up for the high school soon too. And you can also use them for your own paint party at your house. So with that segue into, a lot of my friends and people that want to learn how to paint are doing paint parties at home. And this painting, Handy Little Snowman, is actually going to be for a home paint party that I'm doing coming up this month too. So this is the demo painting for that one. So as well with the public parties, doing home parties, and so that gift certificate could work for that too. Or if you want your own professional, hey, I'm not so much into painting, but I really would like you to do a painting for me. I could do all kinds of personalized gifts. Basically, if you show me an idea of what you're looking for, I'm happy to paint it for you. Or if you want to help somebody else and tell them, I love you, I want to give you a painting, but I don't know what you want, they could get a gift certificate kind of like that towards a painting. So I thought that was a pretty neat idea. For the home paint parties, I've got this handy dandy, like 9-page ideas for paintings. So if you're like, well, I've done the paint parties, but I never like what they have. Well, great thing when you have your home paint party is that you can basically pick whatever painting you want. I've got a list of ideas, but if you've come up with something kind of like, she was like, well, with the Zoography one, she was like, well, you pick what? And I was like, well, I want to make sure that this matches you and your theme. What do you guys really like? Well, she said everyone loves their wolves. So she said maybe like a wolf or a fox. So then I searched out and kind of found something that would work catered towards them. So definitely really open and flexible to make it something unique and special for you and your own paint party.
And you can go on our website to view your portfolio. And there's many, many that you've painted. And there's many that were commissioned pieces. So you've painted, 50-some?
I think it was 46.
46 paintings this year. And how many of them have sold already?
I believe 21.
That's incredible.
I believe 21. Thank you. And 9 of those were commissioned. 9 of the 20 or 21 were commissioned. Basically, they showed me an idea, or they had a picture or a painting or a photograph that they wanted me to kind of replicate, and I was able to do that for them, which is pretty cool.
So the website is McCormick-Meadows, and I'm typing it in the thing right now, I'm going to leave it as a comment, .com, McCormick-Meadows.com.
Thank you, Bill.
And so they can go there. Also, follow us on Facebook so you can watch all these episodes. Follow the McCormick Meadows because we're not always going to do this on Chris's personal page. But she has a lot of paintings that are for sale on there as well.
Yep, as well as at Sweet Caroline's. I've got most of them there now. So if you want to check them out, like all on a gallery wall, which is pretty amazing for me. I've always wanted to display my artwork. And so just the ability to have them up in a store is kind of a dream come true for me.
Lisa McCormick joined.
Hey, Lisa.
Hi, Lisa. Merry Christmas.
So what I'm doing right now is how I told you with layering. So I have the base layer. So usually I start with the middle color and then I add lights and darks. So since the other one was darker, I went ahead and I'm adding the brighter green in here. And you can already kind of see the difference in kind of texture and layers. It brings it up off the page. And what I do there is I just kind of pick places to highlight. You're not going to cover it completely, but you're going to go over the same strokes. So if you feel like from watching this that you're not learning how to paint, that's okay. Because when you come to the painted party, it's going to be mostly instruction. Whereas this tonight is a little bit of everything, kind of telling you all that we're doing right now, as well as kind of showing you a painting at the same time.
We're going to do more of these episodes. I'm hoping to do one maybe every 2 weeks or so.
That'd be cool. What I'm going to do right now is I'd like to really highlight some areas. I want it to kind of look like snow. So I'm going to have this brush dipped probably partially in green and then the other part in just straight white.
I want to give a shout out to Cody Cohill. for this great fancy grape juice she left at the house last night that I'm enjoying while watching you paint.
You're a non-alcoholic beverage over there.
That's right. That's right. Let me ask you this, Chris.
Yes, babe.
Did you know that the EPA is trying to ban glitter?
I did hear that.
How does that affect you and your...
I'm feeling some kind of way about it in both ways. Because one, I did not realize that glitter was non-biodegradable. And so that makes me sad. And two, I kind of really like glitter, being that if you look at our Christmas tree right now, we have a glittered Christmas tree. So yeah, I'm feeling some kind of way about that in both ways.
They may come and take our Christmas tree away.
They wouldn't know what to do with it. There's so much glitter on the Christmas tree. Patrick won't touch the tree.
Nope.
I have to put it up because it is legit gold glitter up and down it. Oh, man.
Well, let me tell you, when we first bought that tree, I'll tell the story why you're painting your tree up there because I think it applies because that looks like a nice little Christmas
happy
tree.
Happy little tree, yeah.
So when we bought the glitter tree, she took me to Walmart to buy a new tree, and she says, I want this one. Well, it was the last one in the store, and they didn't have a box for it. The thing is covered in glitter. Everyone knows I drive a Prius. Yeah, yeah. It's not a joke now. Go ahead.
Yeah,
there you go. That was your opportunity. So, so I had to put the the glitter tree in the back of the Prius, and I also had to put my at the time I was a floating lieutenant in Hampton, and I didn't have a gear bag, so I was extra concerned about having to put my gear on top of all of the leftover remaining glitter. I had to pull out. It looked like my Prius had pooped glitter on my turnout gear. Was that appropriate for episode one?
I guess.
Artsy crafts.
Hey.
Becca says y'all are the coolest.
Aww.
And JC says, Def, get me in touch with you guys about paint party after holidays. Coworkers would love this.
Heck yeah, they would. Bring me all those Geico people.
You're getting a lot of hearts and thumbs up and wows.
Aw, too cute. So a lot of times with acrylics, you kind of have to let things dry. So since I'm going to do a tree kind of over it, I want it to dry just like a tiny little bit. But that's okay if it smears into it, because the one on top of it's going to be more in the foreground. It's going to be closer to me. So it's probably going to be a little bit darker. The way to make something look like it's closer to you is that whatever is closer to you is going to be the darker thing, and the thing in the background is going to be lighter. So in saying that, I think I'm going to put just a little bit more light on this back one, because once I do something on top of it, I can't really go back and change it. I usually do sing to myself, by the way. BT-dub.
Abby just joined.
Hey, Abby.
Some people have had to go. One person you should give a hard time is Nikki. Didn't charge her phone before the airing of the episode. We gave her plenty of chance with all of the warnings. She said she's going to come back on as soon as her phone has some charge on it.
There's a thing called an electrical outlet that you can put a charger into. I'm just
kidding. Rough her out.
I know. I'm brutal. It's okay. She'll forgive me, I hope. So I'm still just adding more layers of light on this one since I do want the other one to be darker. So I'm going back in. I notice I haven't washed my brush or anything yet. I'm just adding, going back in with the white and green, layering up as I go up the tree, going smaller. Left, middle, right. That's kind of all you're doing. Left, middle, right. But I'm feeling like I like that one. Does it look pretty?
Yes.
Yes. Yes! let's see. Oh, you know what? While I'm kind of waiting for that to dry, big tip with paintbrushes, goodness y'all, don't let me be a paintbrush Nazi, is when you are kind of in between doing things, you really do want to wash them off really well if I'm going to let it sit for a little bit.
And pickle juice,
yeah. You know, since I'm using green, it does kind of look like milky pickle juice right now.
They can't see it on your, but they can see it on McCormick Meadows, the live stream.
Because you're so fancy. But you definitely don't want to leave paint on your paintbrushes, because it'll dry on there, your paintbrushes will harden, and you really won't get much shelf life out of them. So I'm making sure I get all of that off of there on the in-between, because I don't want it to mess it up. A lot of times, too, I've found that just wiping things off on a paper towel, you realize how much paint is still on there. You always want to straighten out your brushes, too, like being that this is a flat brush, in order to keep a nice chiseled edge. What I mean by that is just a sharp edge, which you need for fine lines like that I did with the tree. You always, too, when you rinse it off, you kind of shape it back. So when it dries, it's drying in the shape that it was. So while I'm kind of waiting for that other tree to dry, just a second, I can show
you. Why
do you
have to wait for that tree to dry? Because you're going to be putting
another one on front of it. I just want to dry just a tad.
Megan Hopkins said, I bet vinegar really helps to break up the paint and wash it off.
It probably would. So this handy guy.
It's a smelly painting.
Oh, that would be really stinky. I'm not a fan of pickles. I never was. I never ate pickles when I was preggers. I'm just not a pickle person. Sorry, Patrick. I know he loves pickles. Can you see this okay? Am I holding it close up? All right, so this snowman guy is one that I made. You can kind of see, actually, I'll show you the snowflakes. Can you see the snowflakes?
Stand by. There's a slight delay. I can see them when you hold it back. I'm sure that I can see it once.
You can kind of see some of the snowflakes I did on this one because I really like that one. I'm a big fan of this car and the presents and everything and how it turned out. And if you know me, you know I have terrible, terrible handwriting.
Yes, you do.
So I may be able to paint beautifully, but my handwriting is just awful. So I'm always kind of proud of myself, you know, pat myself on the back when I, because I do all this by hand whenever I write on something. So the way I trick my mind, if I go slow enough, it's like a painting. So I did this by hand. It wasn't like printed on there or anything like that. But this painting is actually for sale. This is not a paint night painting just because of how long it takes to do.
How long did it take you to do that?
It was about 6 hours, six-ish hours, I believe.
It's actually pretty good with all the detail that you put in there.
Yeah, maybe up to seven, but about six to seven hours probably. But I'm a big fan of this one. This one is actually for sale. So if you need some new Christmas decor or a gift for somebody that you know loves kind of nostalgia or snowmen or things like that, this is available. It's on sale for $95 right now. So if you would like a Chris McCormick original, this one could be yours. So just let me know if anyone would like that. You can comment sold on that and I will get it to you.
Ramona Stone says you can send me a painting for Christmas. So I'm guessing that also says, how do I get one of your paintings for How do they go about getting a painting from you?
Well, what we would do is just give me a shout out, a text, phone call, whatever it may be, Facebook message. A lot of people message me that way.
Email.
Email works too. It's McCormick Meadows Art @gmail is my email. Pretty easy since our land, we call it McCormick Meadows. But if you'd like a painting or like want to have a gift idea for somebody that you want to do, just give me a shout out and let me know what you're looking for, or if you want me to help you come up with an idea, I can help you do that. Ramona, I'm pretty sure you're out of the state, if my memory serves me right. I have a bad one. But I can also ship paintings. I've shipped paintings to Florida, to Pennsylvania for gifts and things like that.
You said ship, right?
I said ship. Oh, my husband.
Your mom and babe just joined.
Hi, guys. Are you still with Emmy? They've been watching my sister's daughter while she was in Germany, so that's nice that they get a nice vacation and they get some time with their granddaughter. But anyway, I can ship, Mr. Firefighter, I can ship a painting wherever you would like it. And what I do is I definitely package them where they're not going to. What are you joking at me over there?
I'm just reading comments. Ramona is in Florida, and Abby says she is shipping her pants, LOL.
Oh, my goodness.
This is still PG-13.
Oh, my goodness.
We haven't broken the line yet.
Uh-huh. Oh, y'all are special. You make me laugh, though, so that's good.
New Bob Ross right there.
All right, let's paint another happy little tree.
Yeah. Knock it out.
Knock it out. So I'm going back to that bright green.
That tree needs a friend.
It does need a friend. He looks lonely. So bright green, and I'm going to add a little more red so it becomes darker. Than the one that was in the back. So I'm just kind of mixing as I go, seeing that I like it. The great thing with acrylic that I absolutely love, because I've done watercolor, acrylic, oil, all of that. But I like acrylic now kind of the best because it does dry quickly, which can be a bad thing, but it's also a good thing. So if you ever don't like something in a painting, With acrylic, great news is just paint right over it and you'll be just fine. A lot of times too is I'll add water. So if I painted something and I didn't like it, I'll add just a little bit of water because it's water-based, and you can use your finger and kind of smear to, you know, get it the way that you want it. All right, so let's plop in this other happy little tree.
Now that we've... like being God, you can just rain and wash it away.
I wouldn't go that far. All right, so we're gonna paint another happy little tree and we're gonna down like we did before. I want it to be closer to me, so I'm gonna make it look a little lower on the canvas. And if you're wondering why I have all this blank space up here, I'm gonna put some snowflakes, some stars, and then the saying, "Baby, it's cold outside." So you'll see some of my handy handwriting that I don't do that well. But anyway.
Are you gonna do that live or later?
Later on for sure. You don't wanna be. I'm very meticulous. But anyway, so he's gonna go right here. I'm happy with that one. Notice he's lower down. And we're gonna kind of start on the bottom just like the other one.
This is a he tree?
It's a he tree.
Is the other one a he or a she tree?
You know, it's hard to say these days. It really is.
It's 2017.
Yeah. Get with the program there.
Capital.
Oh, jeez.
You gotta make these things entertaining so people will watch.
I know. I don't know if I would watch me, so
I'm glad. I would love the challenge since I'm not on the camera.
I'm glad Patrick is here, because otherwise I wouldn't last this long with a live feed. I definitely wouldn't. I would feel really silly talking to myself.
You look amazing.
Okay. Thank you. All right, so same like before, we're going sweeping strokes down from the top of our... The reason why I do the line, it kind of gives you a point where so everything's going to match up into it. And most trees, especially like Christmas trees, kind of form in like a triangle. So you want to just sweep down like a... But you start in the middle and I go out to the sides. And it's a sweep and kind of like a flick with your hand out to the side there. It's the bend and twist. Did I forget anything that I wanted to mention yet?
Let the people at home know about these private paint parties. What is a private paint party, and how does somebody have that?
Cool, I could do that. So we call them Painted Love because we did a nice little contest, and shout out to Nikki, even though she's not on here, she won the contest for the name. So a Painted Love paint party is what we're doing. The idea with it is you have them in your home or place of business or wherever it may be, and basically you invite your friends over, you get to pick the painting. So that document that I have, you can go from that, or if you have another idea and it works within, you know, kind of hour and a half, 2 hours for a painting. It really makes it nice to be able to make it your own, and you get to decide what that you're doing. You invite your friends over. I actually create an event for you online, and everyone can purchase a ticket online. The ticket price is just like the normal, would be $35, unless you wanted something more public and a fundraising one. Those would be $40 because more money then goes to the cause. But again, for the home parties, you just have people over. You get to have a good time. Everyone brings some snacks, and then we paint and get to know each other. And again, you get to pick the painting, so even better.
Lionel just joined.
Hey, Liney! Oh, how are you? He's like, I'm not talking to you.
No, he says, wait a minute. He says, how are you guys? He said it to JC, but there's multiple people in you guys, so I assume it's you and JC. Brandy Gaynor joined.
Oh yeah, high school, going back.
Hey girl, hey.
Hey
happy
girl.
Little trees.
That's right, happy little trees.
Lionel says he's doing good. He's doing great.
Great.
Got other people joining on the McCormick Meadows as well. Go ahead and tell them how to join and why it's important to go over to the McCormick Meadows Facebook.
So on McCormick Meadows, we're going to be doing these feeds going in the future. They're not always going to be on our personal pages. So definitely find McCormick Meadows, like it, share it, you know, help us out. We're all in this, you know, together when it comes to helping each other. And we'll probably have contests and, you know, giveaways. You laughing at? contests and giveaways and things like that. So definitely go like that page. You'll be able to also have, you know, of course, easy access to future events. We're going to try and load them on our website too, so you can easily see where the public shows are.
Nancy says Emmy is watching you.
Emmy!
And
she's two.
So that's your youngest viewer. She should be in bed. It's 9:00.
I know. What time is it? Gosh, that girl stays up so late. She stays up later than we
Brittany
do.
Brittany joined.
Hey, Brittany.
Brittany Gunderson.
You know what? I have to give a shout out to Miss Brittany because I have been a longtime painter. I mean, ever since I was a kid. And I always enjoyed it. And then I kind of took a pause for a while. And this past year, Miss Brittany took me to a paint party. And we did a crab. And it just reinvigorated all of this painting. So a lot of this started with you, Brittany. So I thank you very much for inviting me and taking me with your family to the paint party. I had a really good time.
Yeah, it's like a new partial living for you now.
It definitely is. I've got, let's see, 2 home parties this month. There's so far 1 public one, possibly another public one. There's this great kids gym in Williamsburg called We Rock the Spectrum. And we talked about doing, when I went there, took Bryce there, adult parties for painting and kids parties. So we talked about, we just have to nail out a date with the month of December is kind of tough because everyone gets busy. And then I've got the 2 fundraisers coming up, one for Zoography like we talked about on the 16th, and then for Matthew's high school sports team, we're going to do one probably in January now.
So it's, how far would you like to go with this painting before you we call it an episode?
I think I would probably be good there because I need to... What I do for my paintings, guys, is when it comes to something more intricate like the foxes, I actually sketch them out with watercolor pencils, believe it or not, watercolor pencils.
Pencils!
So I want to make sure I focus on that, because I'm going to create my own fox based off of those ideas. When you come to the parties, I'm actually going to have chalk. You can use chalk to put on a painting when you want to sketch something, because I always usually sketch out a little bit, and I want to make sure I focus on that, so I probably won't do that on film. But does anyone have any questions while we're on here before we kind of head out?
We got 10 people watching right now.
Anyone want to know any specific about us or painting or anything they like to say? Yes, maybe.
Hey, Nikki's back. She got a phone charge.
Hey, Nikki.
11 people.
Nikki's going to have a paint party soon. Aren't you, Nikki?
Brandy Gaynor says, where do you live?
Where do I live? In Matthews, Virginia now. We moved to...
Asterisk you. Where do you live?
We moved to the country. We're very blessed in where we live. We've got a bunch of land, and little man's pretty lucky. But I will do paint parties anywhere. Actually, the one next Saturday is in Virginia Beach. And then the one the following week is in Smithfield. So I'm not afraid to travel for a paint party. So you Virginia Beachers, you know I could still do that for sure.
Yeah, we'll probably do, let's see, Matthews, Gloucester, Yorktown, James City County, Williamsburg, Hampton, Newport News.
I'd probably go up to Richmond, too.
Richmond.
If my sister wants me to visit, I'll go up to D.C.
Virginia Beach, Norfolk, Chesapeake, Smithfield, Suffolk, so on and so forth. Lionel says, hey, I'm still really interested in one of your paintings. I believe you sent me a link before, but I lost it. Where can I view some of the paintings?
Cool.
Lionel, you can go to McCormick-Meadows.com, and that's where you'll find her portfolio, most of it anyway. I'm typing it in the comments now.
I also have, we'll put in the comments too, I have Fine Art America. I've got a bunch of paintings on there that you can actually take, for example, that Merry Christmas car. I don't think I've loaded that one, but you could have a lot of my paintings put on pillows, great for gifts. I gave one to my mom, she loved it. But on pillows, on bags, on phone cases, I mean, all kinds of things. So we'll put that in the comments later on too, so you can go back and see that link. Great for gifts. That is mostly run by that company, so they would ship it out and everything to you, but all my paintings are on there. And it's definitely a great gift idea, but you'll be able to see those there too.
And the website's just been completely redone within the past couple weeks. So if you looked at it a while back, it's all new, a lot more updates on it, and we're being more consistent about it. On the Facebook, make sure you follow us on the Facebook, because most people are still watching on Chris's main Facebook. Make sure you follow the McCormick Meadows Facebook, because almost, I'd say every other day, we're doing a picture of the day. We're going to be doing more of these episodes.
Yeah, it looks like that crab is the icon for that, if you see it. That's me. That's a crab painting.
There will be Manly stuff, too. She's going to let me put some of my carvings up.
Let you.
And why don't you show them in a moment, the farmhouse carving.
Yeah, we can do that.
Just because, and just let them know that we... You do the paintings, I do the carvings, and there's going to be a lot of stuff going on. We even talked about possibly doing some country-style desserts live, and just having fun with this channel.
And the last thing I'll say about the painting before I show your sign is how I talk about this one being on the front. It does overlap the other tree, and the last thing I'm going to do real quick is I'm just going to do a couple of light touches in this one just to add a little more depth. Again, the more kind of colors in the same color family you do it, it adds more depth to it. So that's the last thing I'll do. But you can definitely tell by looking at it that this tree is in front of the other tree. That's the idea. Just add this on real quick, and I'll rinse my brush.
Oh, cool. I guess we have to do a 6-hour episode. Well, you say, how long do you think this painting is going to take you if you were just doing it with a group? You're trying to get to how many
hours? An hour and a half, 2 hours. So this, okay. This painting, when I first, it should be an hour and a half, 2 hour painting. That's what it'll be. We're just kind of talking and shooting the breeze and all of that. So my paintings on our website are all probably about 6-hour paintings for the most part. The pricing, accordingly, because the more time you put into it, obviously, it's going to be a little different than a painting that you would do on a paint night, so just because the detail and all of that. I've got some large paintings too that you'll see on the website. There's a large crab that's like 24 by 36. Large oysters, I love painting oysters. All right, let me rinse this. Sorry, I don't want to leave it in the water because I don't want to change the shape of the brush.
Ew.
Ew. All right, it's good enough for government work right this second. Anywho, let me grab this sign real quick.
Stand by. Can you reach it?
Yeah.
Coming back. Don't worry.
So, I'll sit back down so you can see it. This is probably one of my favorite carvings that Patrick's done. This is a farmhouse sign. I like the detail and the font that he used. I don't know if you can see how it's used a different, a router bit, you call it, to get this texture in here.
Yeah, they're all hand routed and
super affordable too. This sign was only $45, but I told him we're not allowed to sell this one anymore. So if you want it, he'll make you a new one, but this one's mine now.
And I can do names like for houses or house numbers. I can do a lot of stuff with that. So that's just one of the other things we do here at McCormick Meadows to try to hustle.
Yeah. Hustle, baby.
So that probably is going to go ahead and conclude episode one. I think it was successful, Chris.
All right.
I like hanging out behind the camera.
Yeah, I know. I don't like being in front of it, but I can deal to do some painting.
I told Chris earlier that I've always, done production, but I've always had to be the front man too. So I really like being the producer and letting her be the front woman.
And if y'all could see what I can see, you would understand why I probably look like I'm looking all over the place, because I got Patrick behind the counter with two computers and I have two cameras, phones, and I'm just like, where do I look? Because I feel like if I look in the middle, then I'm like looking all weird.
And the middle's good.
All right. Anywho, well, thanks so much for joining us. Let us know if you have any questions. Again, email me. Check out the website. Happy to do some paintings for your family, your friends. I've done a lot of commissions. And I'm also happy to hook you guys up with a Painted Love Paint Night gift certificate for your own stockings or friends that you know. And let me know if there's anything I can do for you guys. Have a great night.
Thanks for watching.